Will you turn, please, to Ezekiel chapter 33? Our text, actually, if I were to read it in its entirety, would be verses 1 to 20. However, I shall begin with verse 7 and shall conclude with verse 11. A shorter portion of the entire portion that I would recommend that you read as early as possible. So thou, O son of man, I have set thee a watchman unto the house of Israel. Therefore thou shalt hear the word at my mouth and warn them from me. When I say unto the wicked, O wicked man, thou shalt surely die. If thou dost not speak to warn the wicked from his way, that wicked man shall die in his iniquity, but his blood will I require at thine hand. Nevertheless, if thou warn the wicked of his way to turn from it, if he do not turn from his way, he shall die in his iniquity, but thou hast delivered thy soul. Therefore, O thou son of man, speak unto the house of Israel. Thus ye speak, saying, if our transgressions and our sins be upon us, and we pine away in them, how should we then live? Say unto them, as I live, saith the Lord God, I have no pleasure in the death of the wicked, but that the wicked turn from his way and live. Turn ye from your evil ways, for why will ye die, O house of Israel? It is interesting to note the development of Ezekiel's ministry. First, he was sent to warn the people to flee from the impending judgment. It is an unalterable law that sin will surely come into judgment. It is a fallacy of the human mind to think that one can sin and escape from the consequences of it. Israel had cherished that fallacy. And God had sent Ezekiel to the people to warn them to flee from the wrath to come. Then, when it was clear that the people would not turn, at the close of chapter 24, Ezekiel was instructed to remain silent until the catastrophe had occurred. For then, and only then, would his people be prepared to listen and to obey. It is interesting to note that after the destruction of Jerusalem, the people came to him, and they came with this message, what good will it do for us to turn? What good will it do us now? It's too late, but my friend, it is never too late. It is never too late for anyone that has sinned to return to the Lord. The catastrophe had come. Jerusalem had been overthrown. The people said, it's far past the time of turning. But the message that the Holy Spirit gave to the prophet was, even after the catastrophe, turn ye, for why will ye die? In other words, this is the unchangeable, eternal principle that depends not upon circumstances, nor does there come a time when it is not applicable to the penitent heart. Say unto them, as I live, saith the Lord, I have no pleasure in the death of the wicked, but that the wicked turn from his way and live. Turn ye from your evil ways, for why will you die, O house of Israel? Now the first thing I see in this text is that wicked men are to be warned of judgment. If you will consider verses 1 to 6, there will be no question in your mind, but what we have here, a parable given to the prophet concerning his responsibility to warn the wicked. First, there is a time of peril to a besieged city. Son of man, speak to the children of thy people, and say unto them, when I bring the sword upon a land, if the people of the land take a man of their coast and set him for their watchman. When I bring a time of peril, the Lord, you know, does do just that. God has set a peril to the besieged city, and God has set a peril to the sinful heart. It is a delusion that men cherish, that they can take fire into their bosom and not be burned. But such is not the case at all. And therefore we recognize that every rebel against God